So you never really made anything of this?
I said to myself, I'm going to keep telling this story, and then maybe one day, like a film director or something, is going to get this, and maybe we're going to make something big out of this. Because we can actually prove that we come back with the picture. The picture is the proof. And not only that, I mean, I saw in the mirror, in the computer, on the internet, I'm seeing the same uniform that I saw in the dream. And they said I was in the, I remember being a general in a union. Those are the two things I remember. And seeing that...
So you really want the world to know about this?
Yes, I do want to.
Well, what do you suppose the odds of me getting in a cab with my camera tonight are? And nuts enough to start talking to you about your cowboy. What are those odds?
Yeah, it's true.
What do you think? You think maybe you dreamed it?
Yeah, because I usually, and a matter of fact, I usually tell this story to everybody, but I wasn't feeling too good today. I have like a little cold, and I wasn't, but since you said something about past lives, I said, oh, I got to hit it with this one.
All right, so tell me the story about the dream you had, the first dream you had.
Okay, first dream I had was, I'm looking at an antique mirror, and in the mirror, it's smoke, and the smoke clears, and when I see myself in full uniform. It's a dark blue, has buttons on each side, like silver buttons. I also see like little ropes, how you call that, little things?
Oh, braid? Yeah, braid.
And then I actually see a hat, just like the one I'm wearing. But over here is something like this.
Oh, yeah.
Then my brother told me, when I woke up, he told me, go on the internet, and you'll find the picture, since you got all the information you need, you'll see a picture of yourself in the past. I found myself findagrave.com, and the name of the person is Charles Hamlin. And his father was Hannibal Hamlin. His father was Hannibal Hamlin, which was vice president to Lincoln. And the house still stands to this day as a museum in Bangor, Maine, which one day I want to go and make that trip.
What happened when you saw that picture? What did you think? Did that freak you out?
It freaked me out. When I first saw it, I said, oh my God. It's like the Twilight Zone, to be honest with you. It's like the Outer Limits. To see a picture.
And it was your face?
And you. And
oh, okay, good. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's great. Oh, I like that. It's just a great shot.
And he also has a beard just like this, so you can combine the two
okay,
pictures.
Hold on. Oh, Jesus, John.
When I tell the story, I also tell movie stars too, believe it or not. Kevin Bacon, I told him the story. I told Kevin Bacon the story.
Yeah.
Because he was one of my passengers.
And what did he say?
And he told me if I was a war buff. And I told him, no, I wasn't a war buff. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to tell him that dream. Because I remember seeing Lincoln in my dreams. There was one dream I remember. I'm in a big, there was a big place. It was like a big, huge place. It wasn't a house. It was real big. And I see soldiers coming in and out. And I'm saying, what's going on? Something happened to Lincoln. And then I was reading on the internet and I found out that Charles had a sister named Sarah and they both went to the theater where Lincoln got assassinated. So I was there. Okay, I found another picture. And he's a major. He's not a general yet. Mm-hmm. But he's sitting right next to Ulysses S. Grant. And he's wearing the same hat that I'm wearing now. So now I know why I like these hats. It's like a bad habit.
So would you mind if I do that? If I find it,
no,
I'll call
mind.
You. And then we'll show the world, because this goes out to the world.
Wow.
Wow.